Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you'll get an honest inside look at all things solar. I'm Warren, and in this video, we're going to talk about your electric bill, what different charges are on there, what it looks like before going solar, and what it looks like after going solar. Before we jump into the content, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you'll get notified of future videos just like this. In this video, I'm going to walk you through my personal electric bill. I recently went solar, so I have a good example to show you of what my bill looked like before going solar and what it looks like after going solar. But keep in mind that this is for customers who are under net metering. If you want to learn more about net metering, you can click on the link on the description below. We'll have a video on that for you. Typically on a residential bill like this, there are three or four different charges. There's a customer charge, which is a small amount. On my bill, it's about $8 or so per month, just for being a customer of the utility. Then you have your delivery charges, and those charges are for the utility company to have the infrastructure in place to get the electricity to you, the poles, the transformer, all of the infrastructure that they need to get the electricity to you. And then there are the supply charges, and that's the actual cost of electricity. So when you're shopping around and you're looking to maybe use a third-party supplier for your electric costs, you really need to compare the supply or the generation cost of the electricity, because that's the true cost. But when you're going solar, solar is going to cover and offset all of your delivery charges that are kWh or kilowatt hour based, as well as all of your supply or generation charges that are kWh or kilowatt hour based. Solar will eliminate those. So keep in mind, on your average electric bill, you have three charges. You have a customer charge, you have your delivery charges, and you have your generation or supply charges. One last charge that you might see on your bill is called a demand charge. If you're a commercial, industrial, or agricultural customer, you may have those demand charges on your bill. If you want to learn more about demand charges, you can watch one of our videos by clicking on the link in the description below. So now let's take a look at my electric bill after going solar. You know, you'll notice in the top section of my electric bill, the billing period. It started on July 2nd all the way through August 2nd for a total of 32 days in this billing period. I consumed 480 kilowatt hours during that period. My solar produced 627 kilowatt hours. So there's an excess 147 kilowatt hours there. If you look in the top right section of my bill, you'll see that last month I had 1,215 kilowatt hours in the bank. And if you add in the extra 147 that I overproduced this month, it gives me a total of 1,362 kilowatt hours in the bank. Keep in mind that when you're using solar, the solar energy first gets supplied to your house. And if you're instantaneously using that, that's not captured on your bill. So while it looks like my solar system only produced 627 kilowatt hours in that 32-day billing period, it actually created more than that, but it wasn't captured on the bill because I instantaneously used it. As the solar produced it, I used it in my house. If you're thinking about going solar and you want to be able to capture that additional data, get more insight, consider getting a consumption meter. But this will give you a pretty good picture of what solar would look like after going solar. You have a bank of kilowatt hours that you can withdraw from either in the evenings or in the winter time. And if you overproduce, you add to that bank. Thanks for watching. We hope you found this video valuable. We'd love to hear your feedback in the comments section below.